All right, in this video, we're going to do the hex nut print. In this, we're going to use both the polygon block, which we haven't used before, as well as the threadmill block, which we have not used before. So first thing we're going to do here is go ahead and start a new program. So we'll go to Program Manager, New Conversational. We're going to do some stock geometry. So Part Setup, More Stock Geometry. We'll do a cylinder. I'm going to manually size it. It's going to be in the negative Z. It's going to be 1 inch in the radius. Let's do 3.5 divided by 2. So we'll use some 3.5 inch diameter material here. Center of it is 0, obviously, so I don't need to do anything with my reference positions. I've probably got all the tools that I need set up except for a threadmill. I'm going to go ahead and create a tool 10, and I'm going to set up the threadmill. Now I have two options here. I can do a single cutter or a multi cutter. Single cutter would be just a single point tool, much like you would use if you're turning threads on a lathe. Multi cutter would be an insert that had multiple teeth on it. The benefit of the multi cutter is whatever that height is, I may not have to do more than 1 or 2 revolutions to thread the entire inside or outside of a part. I'm going to select the single cutter. Whichever one you select, when I go to the More Advanced Tool Settings button, you can see that it's going to tell me what it's asking for in each one of the fields. So we're going to do 1 inch for the diameter. I'm going to do a 5/8 shank. 6 inches long is fine, and we'll leave it at two flutes, that'll be fine as well. Now let's make that 3 flutes. It's probably more realistic. Go ahead and hit exit. There would be some speeds and feeds if we were gonna do this in real world. We're not gonna worry about that right now. So tool 10 will be our threadmill. All right, so let's go to our program here. So let's go to input, part programming, milling, select more, and there's polygon. Now I can do anything from a three-sided polygon up to whatever I need. In this case, we need a six-sided polygon and it defaults to that, but I would simply type in the number of sides I need and hit enter. The center of the polygon, where is it located? In this case, it is the 0, 0, so that's good. And we have 3 ways to size a polygon. We have the outer diameter, which would be outside all the points. The inner diameter, which would be inscribed inside, basically what's the width across the points, or we have side length. Our print tells us what the distance is across the flats, so we're going to do an inscribed circle or an inner diameter. That's going to be 3 inches. Now the orientation angle would be if I needed to rotate this feature some degrees around the center point. I don't need to in this case, so I'm going to leave that at 0. We're going to go to 0.1. Let's go down to 1 inch and 20 thousandths. -1.02. I'll break each one of those points. Maybe we'll put 20 thou corner radius on there. I'm going to use tool number. Let's see if we can find a 1/2 inch end mill here. And I'm going to cut on the outside. Yes, I'm going to enable my blend moves. Let's peck this maybe at 0.1, and we're done. So let's hit draw. So now we're going to go around the outside of this, pecking down as we go, and we'll end up with our hex that we need. All right, we're going to go in and do the circle in the middle. I'm going to use the same tool, 119, for my end mill. Go to my next block. It's going to be a milling circle. It's going to be in the center of the part. And I'm going to assume that minor diameter here. I don't really know what it is on a 2-inch, 4.5 threaded hole, but I'm just going to guess. So I'm going to take 2 inches minus 125, which would give me 60 thousandths per side. And then I'm going to .875 divided by 2. Make that the radius. We go to 0.1. Let's go down 1 inch and 20 thousandths to break through. We use tool 119. It's going to be a pocket boundary. And we're going to spiral outward. Let's do that in pecs of maybe an 1/8 inch. Let's go ahead and hit draw. So now we'll have our hex and our hole through the middle. We'll go ahead and copy those two blocks, change the depth in the tool, and go ahead and chamfer everything, and then we'll thread mill this. So I'm going to go to my view screen. I'm going to click on shift, click on one, hold down shift, click on two, get them both. I'm going to copy these two blocks. I'm going to paste them. Now I'm going to change the depth and the tool. So the mill polygon will now only be 30 thou deep using tool 4. I know that's a chamfer mill. Still going to be on the outside of the circle. It's going to be minus 0.03 using tool 4. And this is going to be inside. Actually, I'm going to make this a little deeper. I'm going to make this minus 60, maybe 65. So now we'll go ahead and cut that hex, get the circle through the middle, chamfer them both, and then we can move on to our thread. There we go. So we got a nice chamfer there. Now, next we're going to do milling, more, thread. Just like the slot block, we have three different tabs here. This is going to be the information about the thread, location, where's that going to be, and then the process we're going to use to cut it. So first of all, we need to know what's the radius of the thread. Well, the theoretical radius here is going to be 1 inch. It's a 2-inch diameter thread. We know that it may not be exactly that, but we're going to put 1 inch in here for the radius. The threads per inch is 4.5. It knew the pitch. If I knew what the pitch was, I could put it in, then it would have calculated the threads per inch. But there, it calculated the pitch. This is going to be an inside thread. The start angle is at 0, and there is no taper. We're going to use tool 10. That's the thread mill that I set up. Speeds and feeds would have come in if I had brought them in here. And we have a couple fields here for our radial pec count, radial pec depth. We'll come back to those. So now we're going to do the location. Where is this particular thread? Well, it's going to be in the center of the part, so 0, 0. The Z plunge start, we're going to do at 0.1. The top of the thread then will be at 0. And the bottom of the thread will be at minus 1 inch. Now the strategy. We always want to climb mill, so if this is a right-handed thread, we want to start at the bottom and climb mill out, or come out of the part counterclockwise. So we're going to do a counterclockwise up. So we're going to start in at the bottom, coming up to the top. The process. Do I want to enable cutter comp? Yes or no? In this case, I do. I gave it the exact diameter or radius of the thread. I didn't account for the diameter of the tool, so I want the control to do that. Blend types. Do I want to come in at a helix? Do I want to come in on a ramp, an arc, a line? I'm just going to do a simple line. I'm just going to start in the middle, move out to the radius, and come up. Do I want to start in the center? Yes or no? I want to come down right in the middle of this hole, move over to my radius, and then thread out. Now, the radial pec count and the radial pec depth. That is something that you will have to play with a little bit to get used to it. But let's say that I have 60 thousandths depth total that I want to go. Let's say each one of my passes I want to be 20 thousandths. Well, that means I need to take 3 passes at 20 thousandths to get to my final depth. If I said I want to do 4 of them at 20 thousandths, then that means I'm going to start 20 thousandths inside the hole, taking 4 pecs, moving radially 20 thousandths each time. It takes a little to get used to that. We'll see if we can look at it on the graphics. All right, so we're going to go ahead and draw this. We'll see that we're going to get our hex. It'll put the hole in the middle. Everything will chamfer. And then we'll get to watch our thread mill come up four times to cut that. So if I switch this over to toolpath, I think we'll be able to see the radius or the radial peck counts a little bit better. So here you can see that these red lines are to the center of the tool. And here's our four radial peck counts. So we've got our 1, 2, 3, and 4. So those four, it went all the way to the bottom, it came up, dropped back down, stepped over that 20 thou, came out again, went down to the bottom, stepped over. So we were stepping over radially each time until we finished. So the number of peck counts, radial peck counts, and the distance of each peck count or the depth of each peck count will determine how far away from the inside diameter, outside diameter, whatever you start, and it will then determine how many pecks it takes to get to that final depth. So that's the polygon and the thread mill. Two pretty easy blocks to learn, very powerful ones, and hopefully you'll be able to use those in a lot of the projects you have coming up.